Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from group P13 and we will presentation about multivariate analysis. Our member is Anggita Dewati Putri with present number 7, Hauradia Faiza Amriyali with present number 18, Lestari Bunga Pertiwi with present number 24, Muhammad Taufiqul Hakim with present number 31.
In this situation like this, the product-moment correlation, R, is the most widely used statistic, summarizing the strength of the association between two metrics, interval, and ratio scale variables, says X and Y. It is an index used to determine whether a linear to a straight line, the relationship exists between X and Y. It indicates the degree to which the variation in one variable X is related to the variation in another variable Y, because it was originally proposed by Carl Pearson. It is also known as the Pearson correlation coefficient. It is also referred to as simple correlation, bivariate correlation, or merely the correlation coefficient. From sample of n observation X and Y, the product moment correlation R can be calculated as R equals to the division of the sum of parent xi minus x bar close parent times yi minus y bar close parent from e equals 1 to n with square root to the division of sum of parent xi minus x bar close parent squared time to the division of the sum of parent yi minus y bar close parent squared in from e equals 1 to n. Partial correlation. As in this situation, suppose one wanted to calculate the association between X and Y after controlling for a third variable Z. Conceptually, one would first remove the effect of Z from X. To do this, one would predict the value of X based on knowledge of Z by using the product moment correlation between X and Z, R X Z. The predicted value of X is then subtracted from the actual value of X to construct the adjusted value of X. In a similar manner, the value of X are adjusted to remove the effects of Z. The product moment correlation between the adjusted values of X and the adjusted values of Y is the partial correlation coefficient between X and Y after controlling for the effect of Z, and is denoted by RXY times Z. Statistically, because the simple correlation between the two variables completely describes the linear relationship between them, the partial correlation coefficient can be calculated by a knowledge of the simple correlation alone without using individual observation. Nonmetric correlation. At times, the researcher may have to compute the correlation coefficient between two variables that are nonmetric. It may be recalled that nonmetric variables do not have an interval or ratio scale properties and do not assume a normal distribution. If the nonmetric variables are ordinal on n numeric, Spearman's row, PS, and Kendall's tau, T, are two measures nonmetric correlation size that can be used to examine the correlation between them. But of these steps use ratings rather than the absolute value of the variables, and their underlying basic concepts are quite similar, but vary from minus 1 times 0 to 1 times 0. Regression analysis. Regression analysis is a powerful and flexible procedure for analyzing associative relationships between variables depending on metric and one or more independent variables. It can be used in the following ways. First, determine whether an independent variable describes a significant variation in the dependent variable. Is there a relationship? Second, specifies how many variation independent variables can be described by independent variables, the strength of the relationship. Third, determining structure of the structure or form relationship mathematical equation related to independent variables and depend. Fourth, predict the value of depend variables. Predict the value of depend variables. Predict the fifth, controls for or other independent variables when evaluating a specific variable contribution or variable set. And then, bivariate regression. Bivariate regression is a procedure of derivatives of mathematical relationship in the form of equation between a single dependent variable or criteria metric and one independent metric or variable predictor. Similar analysis in many ways to determine the simple correlation between the two variables. However, because the equation must be lowered, one variable must be identified as dependent and the other as an independent variables. Examples given earlier in the context of simple correlation can be translated into a regression context. Statistics associated with bivariate regression analysis. The following statistic and statistical terms relate to bivariate regression analysis. Bivariate regression model. The basic regression equation is yi equals beta o plus beta 1 xy plus ei, where equals dependent or variable criteria, x equals independent variable or predictor, beta o equals intercept line, beta 1 equals slope of the line, and ei is the term fault associated with its observation. Coefficient of determination. The strength of the association is measured by the determination coefficient R2. This varies between 0 and 0 and 1 and signifies the proportion of total variation in Y that are accounted for by variation in X. Estimated or predicted value. The estimated or predicted value of yi is y bar e, where y bar I equals a plus bx, where y bar e is the predicted value of yi, and a and b are estimators of beta o and beta 1 respectively. Regression coefficient. Approximate parameter b is usually referred to as a non-standardized regression coefficient. VNB, a scatter diagram or scattergram, is a plot value of two variables for all cases or observation. Conducting bivariate regression analysis. The steps involved in conducting regression analysis of bivariate are described in Figure 17.2. Suppose researchers want to explain the attitude towards the city of residence in terms of duration of stay. In the derivative relationship like that, it is often useful to first examine the scatter diagram. Plot the scatter diagram. A scatter diagram or scattergram is a plot value of two variables for all cases or observation. This is customary for the plot of the dependent variable on the vertical axis and the independent variable on the horizontal axis. A scatter diagram is useful for specifying the relationship shape between variables. Plots can remind researchers for patterns in the data or for possible problems. Any unusual combination of the two variables can be easily identified. Here the steps of plot the scatter diagram. First, plot the plot of scatter diagram, and then formulating common models, and estimate the parameters, and estimate the standard regression coefficient, and then test for the significance, and determining the strength of n significance of association, and check the accuracy of prediction, and check residue, and then cross validation of models. Formulate the bivariate regression model. In bivariate regression models, the general form of straight line is y equals beta o plus beta 1 x, where y equals dependent variables or criteria, x equals independent variable or predictor, beta o equals interceptor line, beta 1 equals tilt line. This model implies a deterministic relationship in y fully determined by x. Y values can be predicted perfectly if beta o and beta 1 are known. In marketing research, however, very few deterministic relationship, so the regression procedure adds an error term to account for the probabilistic or stochastic nature of the relationship. The basic regression equation become xy equals beta o plus beta 1 times x1 plus ei, where ei is the term of error associated with its observation. The approximate regression parameters beta o and beta I are relatively simple. Estimate standardized regression coefficient. Standardization is the process by which raw data is converted into a new variable that has a mean of 0 and variance of I. When the data is standard, intercepted assumes a value of 0. Beta coefficient of the term of or beta weights are used to indicate standard regression coefficient. In this case, the slope obtained by the way decline in x by yx is the same as the slope obtained by xs decline in y bxy. In addition, each regression coefficient equals a simple correlation between x and y. Byx equals bxy equals rxy. There is a simple connection between standard and non-standard regression coefficient. Byx equals byx parents sx slash xy plus parent. Test for significance. The statistical significance of the linear relationship between x and y can be tested by examining the hypothesis. H O divided beta 1 equals 0. H 1 divided beta 1 not equal 0. The null hypothesis implies that there is no linear relationship between the x and y. Alternative hypothesis is that there is a relationship, positive or negative, between x and y. Usually, two-tailed trials are performed A at statistic with n minus 2 degrees of freedom can be used, where t equals b with is a b. is AB shows the standard deviation from B and is called a standard fault distribution T. Determine the strength and significance of association. Related inference include the determination of strength and significance of the relationship between Y and X. The strength of the association is measured by the coefficient of determination, R2. In bivariate regression, R2 is the square of simple correlation coefficient obtained by linking two variables. The R2 coefficient varies between O and I. This significance the total proportion of variation in Y that are accounted for by variation in X. The total decomposition of variation in Y is similar to that for the analysis of variance. The total variation SSY can be composed into variation calculated by regression lines SSREC and residual errors of or variation SS error or SS rest as follows: SSY equals SSREC plus SS rest. Check prediction accuracy. To estimate the accuracy of the prediction value, Y bar useful for calculating the default estimate error SEE. The statistic is the standard deviation of the actual Y value of the predicted Y value. Assumptions. The regression model creates a number of assumptions in estimating parameters and testing significance. First, the term's error is usually distributed. For each fixed value of X, distribution Y is normal. Second, the means of all normal distribution Y given X lies in the straight line with the slope B. Third, the mean of the term error is zero. Fourth, variance term error is constant. This variance does not depend on the value assumed by X. Fifth, the term error is uncorrelated. In other words, observations have been drawn independently.
Multiple regression. Multiple regression involves one dependent or two or more independent variable. Questions posed in the context of bivariate regression can also be answered via multiple regression by considering additional independent variables. Additional question can also be answered by some regression. How many variation in sales can be explained by ad spending, pricing, and distribution rates? What does ad spending contribute to describing variations in sales when price levels and distribution are controlled? What sales level can be expected given the ad spending rate, price, and distribution rate? Statistic associated with multiple regression. First, adjusted R-square. Coefficient of multiple determination, F-test, partial regression coefficient. Conducting multiple regression analysis, significance testing. HO divided by R square equals 0. This is equivalent to the following null hypothesis: HO divided by beta 1 equals beta 2 equals beta 3 equals blah 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 equals beta k equals 0. Examination of residuals. The difference between the observed value of yi and the value predicted by regression equation is y bar I. Partial regression coefficients. Y bar equals a plus b1 x1 plus b2 x2. Strength of association. SSY equals SSREC plus SSRES. Stepwise regression. A regression procedure in which the predictor variables enter or leave the regression equation one at a time. There are several approaches to stepwise regression. First, forward inclusion. Second, backward elimination. And the third, stepwise solution. Multicollinearity. A state of very high intercorrelations among independent variables. Multicollinearity arises when intercorrelations among the predictors are very high. Multicollinearity can result in several problems, including 1. The partial regression coefficients may not be estimated precisely. The standard errors are likely to be high. The magnitudes as well as the signs of the partial regression coefficients may change from sample to sample. 3, it becomes difficult to assess the relative importance of independent variables in explaining the variation in the dependent variable. And 4, predictor variables may be incorrectly included or removed in stepwise regression. Next is relative importance of predictor. Several approaches are commonly used to assess the relative importance of predictor variables. Statistical significance, square of the simple correlation coefficient, square of the partial correlation coefficient, square of the part correlation coefficient, measures based on standardized coefficient or beta weights, stepwise regression. Cross-validation, a test of validity that examines whether a model holds on comparable data not used in the original estimation. Cross-validation examines whether the regression model continues to hold on comparable data not used in the estimation. A special form of validation is called double cross-validation. In double cross-validation, the sample is split into halves. One half serves as the estimation sample and the other is used as validation sample in conducting cross-validation. The roles of estimation and validation halves are then reversed and the cross-validation is repeated. Next is regression with dummy variables. Regression with dummy variables will be modeled as y bar I equals a plus b1 d1 plus b2 d2 plus b3 d3. Note that for heavy users, d1, d2, and d3 assume a value of 0, and the regression equation become y bar I equals a. For non-user, the regression equation becomes y bar I equals a plus b1. Analysis of variance and covariance with regression. Regression with dummy variable provides a framework for understanding analysis of variance and covariance. Although multiple regression with dummy variable provides a general procedure for the analysis of variance and covariance, we show only the equivalence of regression with dummy variables to one-way analysis of variance.
Basic concept of discriminant analysis. Discriminant analysis is a technique for analyzing data when the criterion or dependent variable is a categorical and the predictor or independent variable are metric, measured on the at least interval scales. Relationship of discriminant and logic analysis to ANOVA and regression. All three procedures involve a single criterion or dependent variable and several predictor and independent variables. However, the nature of this variable is different. In the analysis of variance and regression analysis, the dependent variable is the matrix or scale interval, whereas in the discriminant analysis, it is categorical. Discriminant analysis model. The coefficient is estimated so that groups differ as much as possible on the value of the discriminant function. This occurs when the ratio of the number of squares between groups with the number of squares in a group for the maximum discriminant score, other Lenard combination or predictor will produce a small ratio. Statistics related to discriminant analysis. Important statistics related to discriminant analysis include the following: 1. Canonical correlation, 2. Centroid, 3. Classification matrix, 4. The coefficient of discriminant function, 5. Discriminatory score, 6. Ancient value, 7. F value and their significance, 8. Means to group and group standard deviation, 9. Collecting correlation matrix in a group, the coefficient of standard discriminant function, 10. Correlation of structure, 11. Total correlation of matrix 1, 12. Will conduct discriminant analysis. B. Formulating the problem. B. Estimate the discriminant function coefficient. C. Determine the significance of the discriminant function. D. Interpret result. E. Assessing the validity of discriminant analysis. Multiple discriminant analysis. A. Formulating the problem. B. Estimate the discriminant function coefficient. C. determine the significance of the discriminant function. D, interpret result. E, assessing the validity of discriminant analysis.
Stepwise discriminant analysis. Stepwise discriminant analysis is analogous to stepwise multiple regression in that the predictor are entered sequentially based on their ability to discriminate between the group. The Likert model. When the dependent variable is binary and there are several independent variables that are metric, in addition to two group discriminant analysis, one can also use ordinary least square or OLS regression, the Likert and the probit models for estimation. Conducting binary Likert analysis. The steps are: formulate the binary Likert problem, estimate the binary Likert model, determine model fit, the test significance of individual parameter, and the last, interpret the coefficient and validate. Formulate the problem. Discriminant analysis deal with the issue of which group an observation is likely to belong to. The probability of success may be modeled using the Likert model, as you can see in the screen. Estimating the binary Likert model. In OLS regression, the parameters are estimated so as to minimize the sum of square error of prediction. Model fit. In multiple regression, the model fit is measured by the square of the multiple correlation coefficient, R2, which is also called the coefficient of multiple determination. Significant testing. This testing is test of significance of the logistic regression coefficient based on the asymptotic normality property of maximum likelihood estimate, and is estimated as you can see in the screen. Interpretation of the coefficient and validation. The interpretation of the coefficient or estimate parameter is similar to that in multiple regression, of course taking into account that the nature of dependent variable is different. An illustrative application of logistic regression. First, we run an OLS regression on the data to illustrate the limitation of this procedure for analysis binary data. The estimate equation is given by, as you can see in screen. Statistical software. First, SPSS and SAS computerized demonstration movie. Second, SPSS and SAS screen captures with NOT.
ANOVA one way. If the factor that becomes the center of attention is one factor, then the ANOVA use is one way. One way because there is only one center of attention. To find out whether there is a difference in population inference, a hypothesis test is performed with analysis of variance. The decision to reject or accept Ho can be determined by making the ANOVA table as a follow.
Tukey's honestly significant difference. The Tukey HST test is a statistical tool used to determine if the relationship between two sets of data is statistically significant. That is, whether there's a strong change that an observed numerical change in one value is causally related to an observed change in another value. In other words, the Tukey test is a way to test an experimental hypothesis.
Two-way ANOVA. This bidirectional ANOVA is used when a surge of diversity is occurring not only due to one factor, treatment. Other factors that may be a surge of response diversity should also be considered. These other factors can be other treatments or factors that have been conditioned. Consideration of entering a second factor as a surge of diversity is necessary when the factor is group-block, so that intergroup diversity is very large but small in its own group. When compiled in a table form, two-way table displays, can you see in the next two slides?
Validity analysis. Open the SPSS program. Copy all this data to SPSS. Click variable view and change the name from variable 1 until 10 to item 1 until 10. And for variable 11, change to total. Click data view, click analyze. Click correlate and click bivariate. Move all data from item 1 until item 10 and total to box in the right. Check percent to tell and flag significant correlation. Click OK. Output will appear like this. From this data, it can be concluded that item 7, item 8, item 9, and item 10 are valid because seek to tell below 0.05, while item 1, item 2, item 3, item 4, item 5, and item 6 are invalid because seek to tell above 0.05. And next, reliability analysis. Click analyze. Click scale. Click reliability analysis. Move item 1 until item 10 in variable box on the right, and total doesn't need to be moved. Make sure it's in alpha mode. And then click OK. Output will appear like this. From the reliability analysis result, it can be concluded that the data is not reliable because the Cronbach alpha number is less than 0.7. This data show that Cronbach alpha data is 0.461. Next, bivariate analysis. First, open SPSS. Click variable view. In the num section, write as an example. In curve section, press values, press this, add value, press 0 and the label tidak bekerja, then press add. Then in value, press 1 and label bekerja, then press add. Click OK. Do the same thing with ASCII, 0 for tidak dan 1 for ASCII. Open the data view and copy the data to SPSS. Click Analyze, then Descriptive Statistic, then press Cross Tab. On the row, move kerja, and on column, move ASCII. Press Statistic, then check T-square and risk, then press continue. Output will appear like this. It was concluded that work effect breastfeeding as shown in the data of mother's wooden work will give breast milk and those who work the don't breastfeed. Continuity correction obtained is 0.016, which mean below 0.05, then the hypothesis is accepted. Next, univariate analysis. Open SPSS. Copy this data to SPSS. Change name to jenis sekolah and nilai siswa. Click Analyze, press Descriptive Statistic, tap Frequencies. Move jenis sekolah and make sure to check the display frequencies tables. Then press OK to get categorical data. Press Analyze again, then Descriptive Statistic, and then Frequencies. Reset. Then move nilai siswa to variable section. Don't check frequencies display table. Then press statistic, then click mean and median. Then press continue, then press OK. Output from numeric data. Numeric data and categorical output data will look like this. It concludes that categorical scale variable that children who attend school in public elementary school among 7 people, the percentage was 58.3%, and the attend school in the private primary school among 5 people, the percentage was 41.7%, whereas for numerical output, the mean value is 83.3 and the median is 84.5.